Hello everyone, and welcome back to another session of Dark Souls 2 PvP and another weapon showcase. This time I am using the Spider Fang, which you get from trading the soul of the Duke's Dear Freya with Weaponsmith Ornifax. Now this weapon is pretty interesting. It's got some pretty cool R2s going for it, and those R2s where you shoot out that little spider web, they do exactly what you would think. They slow down your opponent. So I'll get into a few uses of that a little later on, but let's get started with the weapon itself and the stats required. So, this weapon requires 10 strength and 25 dexterity in order to wield it. It has an E scaling in strength and an A in dexterity, so it's pretty much a typical curved sword weapon as far as that's concerned. The physical base damage on this weapon is 210, and the attack rating on this weapon is 340 while I'm wearing a Ring of Blades plus 2. Keep in mind I am on a 40-40 quality build, and without the Ring of Blades plus 2, the attack rating would be 290. So that's really not too high, but again, it is a curved sword, so that should be around what you expect. The counter damage on this weapon is 110, not 210. The poise damage on this weapon is 10 per hit, and the weight, this is where I got the number 2 from, is the weight is 2 units, so that is pretty decent. It's a curved sword though, so I mean it's exactly what you would expect in that, well, in that respect. So overall it's got a pretty basic amount of stuff. It's nothing really too complicated. This weapon, it really doesn't have anything too terribly unique going for it except for its R2 attacks. Now, its R2 attacks, as I've said before, they do slow your opponent. If you noticed, when they do slow your opponent, when your opponent is slowed, they not only decrease the movement speed, but also change the roll speed of your opponent. So they could have a fast roll, and then suddenly they'll be fat rolling if you hit them. I believe it only lasts for like 5 seconds, but that can be enough time if you want to, combo it with a spell, combo it with a guard break, because people get on the defensive when suddenly they can't move as well. So they will hold their shields up, and they will not be moving nearly as much. So, that's something you can really keep in mind. Usually the opponent will either put up their shield or they'll start R1 spamming. One of the two. I really haven't seen anything other than that happen, so it is what it is. People tend to react the same way to this thing, which is not really a bad thing, especially if you are able to take advantage of it. So, yeah. Now, right here, I put a buff on it just because, I mean, I've started putting buffs on my weapons if the other person I'm fighting starts to buff. It's just something I've started to do, because it doesn't really take much to use flame weapon. I mean, it just requires the attunement slot, so it might have been a little bit of overkill on that fight, though, so, you know, it is what it is, but whatever. So, like in my last video on the Pursuer's Ultra Greatsword, here I am yet again fighting Skies, getting a few more good fights in, just because why not? Nothing really too terribly interesting happens in these fights. I don't get any Ultra Greatsword parries, or I don't think I even get any parries with this, although he does wreck me a little bit later on. He wrecks me hard in one of these fights, and it's pretty fantastic, so I had to include that. Overall, it's a good weapon. It definitely has a few good things going for it as far as the speed of its attacks and the fact that its R2 slow your opponent, and the fact that those can synergize really well with pretty much anything if you are, you know, aware and close enough to take advantage of it. The biggest con of the weapon, I would have to say that the biggest con would probably be the low damage output, but then again, it is a curved sword, and their damage output in this game really isn't too spectacular, so it's pretty much right in line with what you would expect. Now, overall, you know, right there, this is the fight he absolutely wrecked me in. As you can see, fantastic. Anyway, overall, I would definitely recommend picking up this weapon because it has a lot of really cool uses and is just really kind of fun to use. It's not the heaviest hitting thing. You'll also notice that I put on the, the Bracing Knuckle Ring plus 2. I put on that because its R2s drain your durability very fast. Without the Bracing Knuckle Ring, you're only able to use a total of 4 of its R2s before it'll break. So that being said, put on the Bracing Knuckle Ring, you'll be able to use like 10. I didn't actually count it out, but you're able to use a lot more. I was able to go through about 6 before I got distracted. I got invaded, so excuse me for being invaded. I stopped counting after that, though. I was able to go through 6, and it still had about half of the bar left, at least. So, it's decent. It definitely does do good work, and I would, as I said before, recommend picking it up. So, yeah, this is the last fight, if you could call it that. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, found it helpful in one way or another. Sorry if I was a bit rambly in this one. It's a bit early in the morning, and I don't know. I probably should get to sleep, but I've got another commentary to do, so it is what it is, guys. Sorry about that. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys next time.